I've probably been on this mic more times than I care to be in the last 2 years. My heart breaks to even have to be here again, but I'm gonna try to compose myself and just say what needs to be said. In the world that we live in today, I know that my colleagues, and I work with both of the last two speakers, and I love them dearly, but we're gonna get down to the nitty gritty, we're gonna talk about the money, because that seems to be what makes the clock tick in East Ramapo now is the money. So let's talk about the fiscal issues. TAs make up a very small amount of budgetary spending. I happen to also teach in the Early Childhood Center. I've taught everything in this district, K to six. I've been around the block and around again. So I've seen the ins and outs of many buildings on different levels. So I get where you're coming from, where things need to be cut, but let's talk about things that need to be cut without hurting the children. But I digress. TAs, if you look at them on the list of budget, make up a small percentage of our budgetary savings by cutting them. Compared to other groups that could be cut, it's almost laughable the amount of money that you would spend on TAs compared to spending them on other programs. They are the elusive 3-for-1 special. They help us with our academic support for our children. They help with the social nurturing of the children when the teacher cannot be on the spot all of the time. And they also serve as monitors and aides in every capacity and fashion within our school. The TAs are critical, and they help to serve a need, full day, half day. There's no word to sum up their need in the building, especially when you talk about some of the other cuts that you intend to make. I want you to get into your mind 300 plus 4- and 5-year-olds with no AP, no social worker, no TA, 27 in a class with one teacher. Get the picture in your, I don't know if you've ever seen a 4- or 5-year-old, but put them five together, 24 to 27 of them. God help us all. But I digress. The program, our program was started with, I call it Obama money, but it was federal stimulus money that we are never going to get our hands on this century ever again. So it was used wisely, it was used responsibly, and it would be a shame to have that money go to waste. The amount of time that was spent to set up this early childhood center, thinking into the future, which was done when we created the center. If New York State mandates kindergarten next year, how do you justify having to reset a program that already existed using money that we don't have? Just think about this. The amount of money we spend training teachers, training TAs, to then dismantle a program that you put so much money into. Not just the training of the teachers, the technology department in setting up smart boards and setting up computers, the buildings and grounds department, taking apart bathrooms, resetting toilets, because 4- and 5-year-olds cannot go to the potty in the toilets that we have for the freshman center. They turn that freshman center basement into a creative, loving environment for 4- and 5-year-olds. And to just take that away is so fiscally irresponsible, it is beyond words. I heard the bell and I apologize. Research shows for every $1 spent on early education, about $9 will be saved in remedial education, juvenile delinquency, and incarceration costs. How many more reading teachers, ELL resource teachers, and speech therapists will you need to hire when those first, second, and third graders have not had a year of kindergarten? How many more social workers and psychologists will you have to rehire to come in and deal with the angry, frustrated third to sixth graders who were created because we didn't meet their needs at the foundational level? We know there's sacrifices that need to be made. Blood has to be shed, but it doesn't have to be shed by our children. Let's think humanely. Let's make decisions that are sound, educationally sound, while making cuts that are fiscally responsible. We are asking you to please come and visit our Early Childhood Center. Please see firsthand. Some of you have been there, but many of you newer board members have not. Come see firsthand what we do with the children in East Ramapo. Both the children who are served by special needs and the children who are served by regular ed. Continue to support the preservation and the growth of the ECC full-day kindergarten program and give our children, all of our children, hello, sir? Sir? I'm sorry, all of our children, the opportunity and the strong foundation that they deserve. Thank you.